Greetings, and welcome to Conan's Guard.
I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Prepare yourself.
Apple doesn't fall far.
The Dwarf King captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Dragon skin is powerful?
Aye, lad. Won't be powerful.
Ned is having fun with you.
Oh, I need it. That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
Thank you.
enemies ahead! Follow me, Atreus. Enemies ahead!
Wolverine! Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vadergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic. The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness. Find out, but a rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
You think this dragon?
Ha!
Focus up!
You enjoy freeing them?
Well, yeah. Still seems like the right thing to do.
Is over. Here, boy.
Yes, sir. This is good to know.
Prepare yourself!
Take this! Flex save, brother!
There are many legends behind the clay grafita. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. The one constant is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so. Yes, sir. Looks like we need three. I don't know. Less ruin, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Here, boy. Another one.
Starcutter. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. They're getting louder. They sound almost like...
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signier.
Over here.
Wonder who wrote this. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bug spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
God. Maybe I can fly.
No, no! gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
I'm confused. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
You boys look right beat.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Work it is. Now, what was the other thing? Don't be too careful now. Looks good. Scuff that up. One of these days, you're gonna tell me who made those beauties. Now there's something else.
Here's room. This is it.
We're inside. What is this place?
Your guess is as good as mine, little brother.
The tree! We're underneath the realm travel room. But why is the floor on the ceiling?
Those realm doors seem to mirror the ones above.
The same magic to protect the Black Rune. The clue we seek may be inside.
Huh. Right next to the Odinheim door.
Interesting. But can we reach it?
Not from here.
Oh! What's behind there?
Well, one inner sanctum within another.
Those tapestries. Looks like more giant art. Whatever Atreus did for them must have been big.
This is the rune for Jotunheim.
That's right. And look, we're on the other side of the door.
The upside-down door.
What are you thinking?
Stand back.
Okay. It's moving!
What's moving?
Everything!
Extraordinary. The whole room is built on some kind of axle.
There's chains on both sides. Without those...
We can flip the temple.
All right!
Do you... what now?
Uh-oh. Things are happening. Okay. I don't think they're attacking.
Boy, on the statues.
I see them. It says boy.
Hmm. Ominous.
Go on. Read.
Before the first, after the last. Nothing between, no shadow cast. Oh.
Are you quite sure flipping the temple is the only way to reach them, whatever it is?
You said there would be a path. The temple can be flipped.
Therefore, we flip the temple. The logic is unassailable. Not sure what happens when we recklessly upend a room that's rooted to eight other realms. I'm curious, of course, but it's a leap to imagine it gets us to Jotunheim.
I don't mind a leap.
Well, who knows? Perhaps you and Tyr are the same kind of mad.